Right now, Mana is sitting at $3.59, the lowest point it has actually been since the 18th of November, so quite some time since we've re-hit this particular point. So does this actually mean this is now the perfect time to buy up the Decentraland dip? Is it going to continue going further down? Is now the perfect investment opportunity? And should you potentially be looking into selling Mana or also alternatively investing into different cryptocurrencies or metaverse plays? That's what's going to be the focus of this video right here. So thank you guys for tuning into this video right now. This is going to be your latest and most necessary Mana update video so that you actually know where is the whole market progressing, especially in focus of Mana. So first of all, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for tuning in to this video. So we're going to be covering everything that is surrounding the topic of Mana, the current price, the price prediction, and the up and coming outlook of where Mana Decentraland is going to be going in the next few days. Now, my name is Vilius, and on this channel, we talk about Mana, Sandbox, all other metaverse projects, crypto gaming, NFTs, in general, DeGen plays, and anything that should hopefully make your future self rich. That's the goal of this channel. I want to help you guys figure out the best possible investment opportunities and what you should actually be doing in terms of metaverse and investments and how you can actually progress in this crypto market. And if that's something that is of any interest to you, keep in mind we're doing daily videos on the channel. And if at any point in this video you actually do enjoy this video and want to see more Mana updates, leave a like so that I know you guys enjoy these Mana videos, and subscribe down below so that you do not miss out on any future uploads. Now, enough self-promotion if you'd like it. Now, let's actually dive into today's video. Now, first of all, we need to take a look at the overall market sentiment, as it is very much important to the whole price point of Mana, what Bitcoin, Ethereum, and other major cryptocurrencies are doing as a whole, and how this actually impacts the entire market. Now, over the past weekend, we saw a massive, massive crash, especially for Bitcoin, which drove the entire market price down quite heavily, as we can see right here, with almost a price dump of over 30%, which led to a lot of portfolios and wallets bleeding, including mine. I was hit quite heavily, as a lot of Metaverse projects did dump by 30 to 40% across the weekend. Obviously that hurts, but I'm very optimistic in the future outlook of things. I do not believe these investments are gonna be hurting for too long, as I do believe these will be rebounding anytime soon. Maybe it will take a little bit longer than projected for these to hit these all-time highs and these juicy gains that we're looking for. But keep in mind, when there is fear in the market, there is always money to be made. And if you believe in the long-term vision and these are core products with solid fundamentals, solid teams, and they're gonna be building out the best potential product for this exact ecosystem, regardless of the current market situation, now could be a fantastic buying opportunity, but on the same time, it could be going even further, as a lot of people did not predict this exact crash to happen right here, even briefly down to 42,000. Think about the meme culture as Bitcoin hits an all-time high at 69,000 and then hits a new local low at 42,000. And this dip was bought up semi-nicely, and over Saturday, it looked like we could be recovering for Sunday, but instead we did see another dip right here, which led to the market bleeding once more, as we in fact did not manage to do a good weekly close. And right now, Bitcoin is hovering at $48,800 with below a $1 trillion market cap at $920 billion, with a volume traded of minus 9%. Now, we've seen other projects such as Ethereum actually hold up very, very well. So did Solana. We even saw Terra Luna making some fantastic new gains, creating all-time highs yesterday briefly at $77. We saw Avalanche do quite significantly after their massive run-up. Polygon has been doing very, very well, surprisingly. I'm happy that I managed to pick up Polygon at $1.66. Actually, I think $1.62 in the recent drop right here, where we saw Polygon dip actually quite heavily, and that's when I managed to reinvest into Polygon quite heavily, reallocating some funds, and that was a wise move on that side. But not all investments over the weekend and the past week were as fruitful as Polygon, for example. Now, if you actually look at the fear and greed index, we're currently sitting at 16, which is signalizing extreme fear. This is something that we haven't seen in a very, very long time, but do keep in mind, when the market is extremely fearful, extremely bearish, Twitter feeds, social media, etc., this is something you'll be able to see when we actually take a look at some potential crypto projects that haven't seen this particular low in ages, and a correction was bound to happen. Just looking at the entire yearly crypto fear and greed index, 18 is the lowest point that we've actually managed to hit since July and May, after the massive crash where we were somewhat in a bearish phase throughout the summer, after revisiting and gaining more optimism leading up to August and also September. This is something you desperately need to keep in mind with the whole entire crypto market. If the entire market is overly optimistic, super, super bullish, That's when you should be fearful, because people overestimate the power. In my opinion, this is not the big investors, but actually the whales that are actually manipulating the market. When everyone is very, very greedy, want to keep on holding their position, they're not going to be taking profits. They're putting up bigger long trades, overexposing themselves with huge leverage trades. That's where the entire market is going to be flushed out, and where the big higher powers are going to make the massive money moves. And this is something that you should desperately look out for, especially when there hasn't been a correction in a longer period of time, which we hadn't seen since recently in May 2021, where we had a massive flush out of a 30-40% dip. A 30-40% dip, yes, granted, this is the biggest dip that we have seen since May 2021, but this is a necessary dip that will only extend the bull cycle beyond what a lot of people projected was going to be in November and December of this year. And Benjamin Cohen, a very smart person, a very smart YouTuber that you should definitely follow in terms of Bitcoin, as I like to say that I'm by no means necessary a Bitcoin expert. I just follow a lot of smart people, whether it is on social media or on Twitter, which is inevitably a social media. It seems like more people are calling for a multi-year bear market right now that Bitcoin is at 49,000 than when it was at 29,000. Sometimes you need to zoom out. And this is a very true point in my opinion. And this is a very fair point. If we actually think back to May 2021, a lot of people were very optimistic that the bear market isn't here yet. The bull market is still going to continue, hit the new all-time highs. But now recently, where we've restabilized at a much more solid level with a correction that was inevitable and necessary, it just wasn't really predictable due to a lot of circumstances that occurred. A lot of people are a lot more bearish, which is very, very surprising to see. And I want you guys to remember that Bitcoin dictates the market, even with crypto gaming and other different segments within the market. Whatever Bitcoin does, it impacts the entire market as a whole. And under circumstances, we did have a black swan event as the whole market was overbought in terms of spot market. A lot of over-leveraged trading positions with 10x leverage, 100x leverage that were put in a long time ago. And a lot of people were liquidated and flushed out throughout the weekend. We also had the massive news and the introduction of the Omicron COVID variant. And that was the last case that we had it back in March 2021, where this was first initially announced. And we had a massive dump in March 2021, which was also a fantastic buying opportunity for a lot of new early investors. Then we also still had more news regarding the Evergrande scenario. And also, last but not least, in my opinion, what I've stated previously is that I believe the market is still being controlled by massive whales, and we are all just little players, pawns within the system, where these big dogs are actually making some huge money moves, where the market is actually being manipulated by massive whales. But I could be wrong. This is just my opinion. But this is not why you guys tuned into this video. I just want to preface this in advance, as it is important to understand, okay, why is actually Mana and the whole entire crypto gaming market tanking like it is, as we've seen with a lot of different crypto projects, seeing some massive hits. Now, granted, right now, they aren't looking too bad on the first look. But if we actually look at the weekly spectrum, we saw a lot of these projects get tanked quite a bit. Polka City, which I am invested in as well, minus 60% over the last 7 days. UFO Gaming, also a big project, took a hit. Atari Token, minus 50%. We also have other projects such as Defina Finance, minus 46%. A lot of big projects, also Infinity, which I am long-term very bullish on, minus 43%. Vulcan Forge, D-Race, some huge projects really took some severe hits throughout this week. And then looking in comparison, some of the bigger projects did manage to stabilize somewhat decent, especially looking at Decentraland, Mana, Axie Infinity, and also Sandbox going down only approximately 25%, which is still obviously a big hit, but nonetheless, it is manageable. And also looking at the whole market capitalization, looking back a few days ago when actually talking about top Metaverse tokens, this has gone down by almost 10 million. And if we actually look at the whole market cap, actually going down by a total of 14 million as a whole. And what we've also seen is a decrease in volume by minus 33% for Mana right here. Ultimately, this just means that the entire bull market is going to be stretched a little bit longer. I do believe we will see a consolidation phase, not only for Bitcoin, other altcoins, and also the crypto gaming market, the metaverse, etc. This could be a fantastic opportunity to get back into NFTs. Possibly the NFT market will be restabilized, as a lot of these projects, including Ethereum, Solana, etc., the main NFT platforms, will start consolidating, and people will look to make money in other markets such as NFTs, as we've seen previously. Also, David Gokstein, hopefully I didn't mispronounce his name. This is a perfect opportunity to look at Mana and also Sand. Always a good bet to own property, whether it's in real life or virtually. So even if the whole price point of Mana isn't doing too well, this could still be a fantastic point to actually invest into different NFTs or look even further into different metaverse projects, especially NFT gaming. But when looking at the grand scheme of the actual chart for Mana right here, ever since hitting the all-time high in November 24th and November 25th, when looking at the 4-hourly chart, we saw that it had been descending ever since. And we were somewhat coming into a squeeze right here where we potentially could have seen either a break upwards or downwards. But unfortunately, we did see a massive break downwards right here, actually briefly even going down to $2.50, which is a level that got scooped up very, very quickly, as a lot of people had put in buy orders at this exact position right here. And we saw pretty much every single altcoin dip to this one position where Bitcoin did this massive unpredictable dive right here. And that was entirely normal to see right here. Now, me personally, I wasn't looking into investing or selling Mana at this given time point until we saw a little bit of a closer signal, whether we're actually going to break down upwards or break down downwards. So this was something that I was waiting for, in fact. But unfortunately, we did see the breakdown downwards. But unfortunately, due to unpredictable circumstances, that was quite hard to predict. Now, in terms of the things that I am personally looking at and looking for, is actually going to be three different things that I want to see for Mana to continue for me to back in, reinvest, or take profits. So pay attention to what I will be looking out for. Now, one thing that we do want to see is, first of all, the 20 EMA and also the 50 EMA to cross back above here. That will be incredibly bullish for Mana in general. But also, what we want to see is for Mana to retrace back to this 30 level EMA that you can see right here. It is the orange line, as that is a crucial level that we've seen multiple times actually hit and retrace once more. We saw it here, we saw it here, we saw it right here. We also saw it a few times right here, also right here. So it's going to be important for Mana to make its way back up to the 50 level EMA, which will probably continue going down like this slightly, and we need to break above it. Now, we will see rejection at first, but hopefully, inevitably, we will manage to break above this crucial level of resistance and then create a new support level right here. Beyond that, another crucial level that I will be looking out for is to actually manage to come back to this descending level of resistance and actually retest it, hopefully even break it. And this is going to be also a significant point that we need to actually come back, retrace, and actually go through. This is going to be an important level. So we first of all have the 50 EMA and also this key level of resistance. And also, last but not least, if we actually drop the Fibonacci retracements from the top right here down to the bottom, which was right here, close to $2.50, it is going to be important to actually go into this golden pocket right here between the $4.20 mark and $4.63 mark at the 0.618 Fibonacci retracement level. This is going to be the golden pocket right here that we need to head back eventually. And if we actually manage to get to this level, this could be looking fantastic again for Mana if we actually manage to hit this level. So we got number one right here. We have the 50 EMA that we need to retrace. Then we also have the key level of resistance that we need to break, and also this level right here. These could be fantastic points of entry. But in my prediction, what we will see is that Bitcoin will be slowly but surely continuously regressing a little bit, consolidating. And this could mean that potentially Mana could continue dropping down a little bit lower and refine potential levels of support and resistance. As we can see right here, we had a previous level of support right here where we touched a few times, and we could see this form as a new level of support or resistance. First of all, we need to break above it and create this new level of support. If not, we could see this dropping a little bit lower to previous levels of support and resistance, which could be, first of all, at the $2.90 level, and then potentially, if we don't manage to hold that, even further at the $2.50 level, which we did briefly touch at this dump. But in my opinion, we're first of all need to set up this level of resistance. First of all, we need to set up and break this level of resistance and create a new support level, and then from there on, look on to break out these crucial levels of support. And as already mentioned, if we manage to break the 50 EMA, key level of resistance right here that is in a descending pattern right here, and also the 0.618 Fibonacci level, then we could be looking golden for Mana right here. I still believe that this is one of the best projects in the metaverse right now. Still incredibly bullish right here, but for now I will be sitting on the sidelines, maybe even taking a small portion of the profits and then relocating it into a little bit more riskier place, as in these kind of situations the risky ones do get rewarded heavily. But keep in mind, none of this is actual financial advice. This is just based on my own theories and my own research. But that pretty much wraps up today's video. Hopefully you guys did enjoy this quick Mana update. Let me know what you guys think of Mana right now. Where do you think it's going and what other projects you are going to be investing in, whether you think Bitcoin is bearish or bullish, and where you think Bitcoin is heading in the next few days and also weeks by the end of the year. Love to hear your guys' opinion. And yeah, thank you guys for watching this one. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys back tomorrow. Bye-bye.